Hello, welcome to You Gears. My name is Yana. Today we are going to assemble one of our new models. It's a musical instrument called hurdy-gurdy. A few words about its history first. This instrument takes its roots in the 15th century. Initially, it was a big and cumbersome instrument which was difficult to handle. It was called organissimo. Slowly, it changed and took shape of a more portable version under the name of hurdy-gurdy. The instrument had immediately become very popular among aristocrats in the 17th-18th century. People used to decorate it with rocks and encrust it. Back then, the hurdy-gurdy music was referred to as a medieval rock and roll. We liked this idea very much, and so we decided to recreate the instrument of that era, and thus we created the hurdy-gurdy construction kit, which you can assemble with your own hands and have a great time doing so. So, let's begin. Open the box and take out the model. As you can see, it includes 8 boards with parts and instructions. It also includes auxiliary tools, a model of a hammer, rosin, wax, strings, rubber bands, and a piece of sandpaper. Now, let's see the purpose of each tool. Open our instructions. You may also need a trim knife and nippers. I also prepared some additional sandpaper and wax, but as they are supplied with the model, we will not need them. Carefully cut open the package. Let's read the instruction first. The first 2 pages give us a very important information that we should extract pieces with extreme care. If a piece can be extracted, try to use the knife. We also have this helper to extract parts. You can use it too. If pieces wouldn't insert or connect well, you can use wax to facilitate the process. Then we can see the following signs. Do not ignite the wax. Use extreme care while working with sharp parts to avoid injuries. Throughout the instruction, we will see the following symbols. Symbol 1. Wax the part. Symbol 2. Sandpaper, sand or trim the part. Symbol 3. Use rosin. We'll need it to grease parts, but we'll discuss it later. Symbol 4. Do not lock the parts, etc. Leave the parts free from locking for a while. Symbol 5. Press down the part until it locks. Symbol 6. Pay attention to certain elements specified in the instruction. Symbol 7. Take care extracting a part from a board. Use the knife to cut the cross pieces to make it easier and to avoid damage. Symbol 8 – rotating element. The piece must rotate or move freely when assembled. And the last symbol – auxiliary hammer model. Here we have this additional model that you should assemble before proceeding to the hurdy-gurdy. So let's put the hurdy-gurdy instruction aside and start with the hammer. Take the knife and carefully open the film to extract the instruction. Start with part number 1. Following the instruction, push out parts number 1 and number 2 and put them together. The teeth here should match. Then parts number 3 and number 4.
Если плохо заходит, можно немного.
You can use some wax to make the connection easier. Now we put these two parts together. Using parts number 5 and number 7. Extract them carefully from the board to avoid damage to the teeth. Please note that the parts have marks. These marks should match and be positioned at the hammer stop. To do this, we align the hole. Insert the part on one side and lock it with the part on the other side. You can use some wax to insert the teeth easily. Connect the lower holes too, using parts number 8 and number 6. In the same way, insert one part and lock it with the second one. Make sure that the marks match. Note the pay attention symbol in the instruction and the figure explaining how pins inside the hammer handle should be connected. Let's do the hammerhead next. We'll need part number 9 and 3 parts number 11 for this. Insert parts number 11 into the holes. The next figure shows that all parts number 9 should be put on the pins. Here you can also use some wax. Do it with all 5 parts. Now it's the turn of the upper part 10. It bears U-Gears logo. Put it on, and the hammerhead is done. Lock it on the hand. Note the position of the wide and narrow edge in relation to the hammerhead. Insert the handle pin into the hole and lock it with parts number 12 and fasten it. Our hammer is done. Now we can start assembling the main model. First, we have to check with the instruction to see which parts we will need. It's board 1. And parts number 1 and number 2 on it. Extract these parts and note 2 arrow marks pointing at each other. Put the parts together like this and align the holes. Now, we need pins number 3. You can find them on board 6. Here's a set of them. We'll need quite a lot, so you can extract the set right away. Extract all eight parts. As I've already mentioned, this model has a helper that makes extraction easier. You can find it on board 7. Here it is. Extract it now to use it for further work. Lightly press down the part at the cross piece, and the part comes out easily. We'll need 8 of them. In case of any burrs left, we can trim them with a knife. That's it. The burrs are removed and we can insert the parts into the big holes. Please note that the holes are narrow on one side of the circle and wide on the other side. We use the wide side to insert the pins and fasten the circles. Thus, circles number 1 and number 2 are fastened to each other. It's very important to remove burrs on the rim surface, as this is where the cord will later touch the wheel. By removing burrs, we ensure a clear and uninterrupted sound. For this, the wheel surface must be smooth.
И сделать это колесо гладким.
Perfectly smooth. One more important thing. Under no circumstances use waxing here, as this surface must provide higher friction rather than low friction. To increase friction, we'll apply rosin to this surface at the end when we feed the strings. Then we need part number 6 and number 7. They can be found on board number 1. And insert them into each other. This can be done with ease. Make sure it works all ages of these parts as shown in the figure, as well as the ages of pins. With which the parts will be locked. Take decorative parts. Part number 5 goes first. Put it on the axle we made earlier. The part has a wide slot and a narrow slot. Make sure to fit the axle correctly. Fit part number 5 all the way through. Next goes the wheel. The pin caps should be positioned towards you. Now, the decorative cover matches the wheel pattern. Part number 4 goes at the wheel's backside. And pushed all the way along the axle. Here's what we have. Then we need parts number 8 and number 9. They can be found on board 1, 2. Extract this set. To avoid confusion in diameters, these parts have marks. This will help you distinguish them in case you have to deal with a number of similar parts. First, we need part number 9. Put it on the shorter end of our axle. Sand the surface before fitting it. Our axle has already been waxed, so we can put the part on all the way through. Part number 8 goes next. Sand the part and put it on all the way through. Done! Parts number 9 and number 8 go at the back side too. First, we put part number 9 on the longer end of the axle, and then goes part number 8 all the way through. Wax the part. Now we need part number 28. You can find it on board 3. Put it on the washer, on the axle. This part should be fitted on the washer at the pin's shorter end. Fasten it with part number 9. Sand it. And part number 10 goes last. Here's part number 10. It's on board 1. Remove burrs to ensure proper engagement of the gear and wax it. Then, extract part number 29 from board 3. Fit the axle into the upper hole. Wax the upper holes first. And then fasten the axle with gear number 11. It can also be found on board 1. Remove burrs and wax the gear before fitting it
на самый край шипа.
At the very edge of the pin. Here's the unit we got. It's still missing parts number 57. Here they are. To fasten the assembly. Two small packs. Wax them and insert them into the empty hole in the center. Thus, we've got the unit called Unit A. Put it aside and go to the next step. On the next page, we see that we need parts number 15, number 16, and number 3. carefully take part number 16 out of board 1. Then we need four parts number 15. Here they are. There's also one spare part. We currently need four primary parts. Remove burrs to ensure proper rotation of the gears. Four parts, number 3, go next. Take them out of the set. Remove burrs. And assemble as shown in figure. Wax the part surfaces and teeth first. The surface of part number 15 and teeth. There are four of them. Now we can insert a pin into the round hole of part number 15 and lock it in the hole of part number 16. Then check free rotation of the gear. Repeat the steps for the remaining gears. To ensure the mechanism's good look, keep the same direction of the pattern. Here's what we get. Then we need parts number 12. Part number 13 and part number 14. Put part number 13 through the hole and fit washer number 14 on top of it. The surfaces can be waxed.
нашу шестереночку.
Feed the five gear assembly on top.
Шестеренками. И
and then we have to feed part number 17 in the middle. Having waxed the surface
внизу по плоскости и
and teeth first.
И совмещаем с
engage the gears. Then attach washer number 18 on top. Like this. Find part number 17 on board 6. Here it is. It holds a set with part number 51. Put it aside for the moment, we'll need it later. Currently, we only need part number 19. Thoroughly wax the inner teeth and fit it on top of our gear assembly. Then, make sure that our gears rotate nicely. Then we have to wax the side pins and take parts number 19 and number 20. They can be found on board 2. Here they are. Parts number 20 and number 21.
И мы смотрим, как должны.
Let's arrange the position of the arrows in relation to our gear assembly.
Стрелка сверху.
The upper arrow should be pointed outwards. Fit the part on the right-hand pins. Do the same on the opposite side. The arrow is pointed outwards and positioned at the top. The assembly is locked. Check the free rotation of the mechanism and thus we get unit B, the planetary mechanism. Put it aside for the moment and go to the next step. We'll need parts number 22, number 23, number 24. Here we start assembling the hurdy-gurdy's body. Put part number 24 on part number 22. Making sure that the inscription is inside and the pattern printed on the side part of piece number 22 is outside towards you and connect the pieces. The same procedure should be followed for part number 23. If you face difficulties, you can use our auxiliary tool, the hammer. A few light taps should help you manage the job easily.
должно сложиться.
Then, we open wide the side walls.
Боковые части и
and place the planetary mechanism, unit B, inside. It should be placed against the side holes. As this is where it will be fastened later. Then, take the decorative plates, number 25. You can find them on board 7. Take extreme care while extracting them. In the event you can't do it properly, use the knife to cut the cross pieces. These parts are very delicate and can be easily damaged. We'll also need parts number 26 and number 27. Here they are. We had them on board 2. It's 2 sets with which we are going to fasten the decorative plates.
26.
Part number 26 has a long pin. Part number 27 has a short pin. Align the holes in the plates
на декоративных накладках на
side panels and our inner planetary mechanism
так, чтобы
to match the big hole with the small hole
и шляпкой вверх
and having waxed the pin put it through cap first. One side is fastened at the top. Now we take the short pin number 26 to fasten the plate at the bottom. You can use tea light like this to wax small parts.
И со второй стороны тоже.
Use part number 26.
26 to
fasten the opposite side. Make sure that all holes are aligned and put the pin through and then the short pin number 27. The decorative plate on one side is already fastened. The other side is still to be done. Repeat the same procedure on the opposite side. Align the holes in the decorative plate, side wall, and planetary mechanism and fasten them with the pin. In case a pin is broken or lost, you can use the spare pin. Fit the pin number 26 at the bottom. If you face difficulties pressing the pins with your fingers, you can use the helper. Apply the wider surface of the helper to the pins and apply some force. This makes the installation easier. Part number 26 and part number 27. Done. The planetary mechanism is installed. The side plates are fitted. Now we can install unit A. Pay attention to the part that goes first during installation. There is a smaller part and a bigger part. The smaller part goes towards the planetary mechanism, and the bigger part is directed towards the open end. The installation holes can be waxed, and here we can make use of the hammer. Align everything carefully, because if you do something wrong, you'll have troubles disassembling it. Complete the job with the light taps of the hammer. Fit these two units. Make sure that the gear is aligned with the planetary teeth and the gear's engagement is correct. Rotate the mechanism to make sure that it works properly. Run in the mechanism to ensure the proper operation of the instrument. Everything works properly. Now, we can install the back deck to complete this unit. You can find it on board 3. Here it is. It looks nice with the hardy-gardy inscription. It also leaves room for your own inscription or signature, whatever you like. Install the deck to have hardy-gardy inscription on top. Like this. Put it on corresponding pins. And again, if you feel resistance, you can wax the pins to avoid damage. Carefully fit the deck on the narrower part of the body. And leave the wider body free for the moment. You can see here the symbol "Do not lock the pieces" I mentioned in the beginning. Here's where it comes handy. This is required to install some other pieces before the body is locked to the back deck. Let's put this unit aside for a moment. Let's proceed to the next step. We need board number 7 and parts number 33 and 34 on it. Extract part number 33 and 2 parts number 34. Please note the correct position of part number 33. This tooth-like protrusion should be on your left, and the rounded protrusion should be on your right. Fit parts number 34 into the holes. You can turn them to ensure their proper rotation. And parts number 35. Here they are at the bottom right of the board number 7. Sand these parts thoroughly, as they will be in contact with the screens during raising or lowering them.
Поднимать или опускать струну, и для того, чтобы струна не перетиралась и хорошо.
Sanding allows to prevent wear and tear of the strings. And ensure their proper sliding. You can apply some wax to the surface before fastening the parts with part number 36. Please also note that this part has the same shape as part number 33, only that it's a bit larger and has a pattern on its surface. Position the part with the pattern towards you and put it on pegs number 34. Then, find parts number 37 on board number 8. These ones. It's important to install them in the correct position. This lace-like side should be installed on the pattern-free side. Lock them into the slots. Here's what we should get. On top, we have two parallel pairs of pins for parts number 38 found on board number 7. There's even a spare part in case you have broken one. The parts are fitted with their decorative elements against each other. The pins can be waxed. On the pin ends, we put parts number 39. These parts are two tuning pegs for the strings. This unit is completed. Now, we need the front deck, which can be found on board number 4. It looks very nice with a pattern on it. I'd even say an ornament. We'll need two parts. Number 3. On board number 1. We have this nice looking part that decorates the front deck. It has U gears printed on it. This is how it should be fitted and fastened with our pegs number 3 on the back side. To do this, align the holes and insert the parts like this. Same on this side. That's what we get. Remove the burrs. Now, fit our unit into the front deck. The front deck has four holes, and the unit has four pins. So the unit is fitted now. You can use some wax for the pins if you feel resistance. Here's what it looks like. Turn it around. You can see on the back side a few holes, which we use to fasten this upper unit. To do this, we need parts number 40. You can find them on board number 6. Here's that set. We'll need four parts number 40. You can use the helper. Quite an interesting part. It is spring-loaded somewhat. It can be waxed at the bottom edge. To install the part, lightly squeeze it and place it in the holes as far as possible, giving the part a slight push. Two more parts to go. Slightly squeeze and push them. These parts fasten the screen holder properly from the inside. We can put it aside and go to the next step. We will assemble the decorative panel to which a crank will be attached right here. We need board number 2 for this. Part number 41. Insert pegs number 43 as shown in the instruction. The part should be positioned with its pattern towards you. Take part number 42 out of the same board. And put it on the pegs we have just fitted. Align the holes. Now, we need parts number 55 and 54, which can be found on board number 4. Here they are. Two parts. Part number 55 and part number 54.
располагаем деталь.
Part number 54 is asymmetrical. The part should be positioned in a way to have the hold bulge on it towards your left. Feet part number 55, holding its sharp protrusion outwards. Then, take the unit we made and attach the hole of part number 55 to the upper left pin. Fasten it with another part number 55 and put the pins of part number 54 through it on the opposite side. This movable top will be used to fasten strings. Now, we need parts number 56. These side plates can be found on board number 3. One part is spare. Attach them on both sides. We get the unit like this. Now we should wax it. Wax the round holes inside, some on the surface and some on the back. The same with the second round hole, inside and on the surface. These holes are intended for rotating elements, the gears. The gears should rotate freely, and we should give the holes good waxing therefore. Now, we need parts number 44 and number 45 on board number 2. Here's that board, part number 44 and number 45. Gear number 46 is on the same very board. Attach parts number 44 and number 45 to each other. In case of resistance, you can use the hammer. And fit part number 46. Our axle is symmetrical, and we can fit part number 46 all the way in at any end of the axle. Then we need another part number 48. Here it is on board number 3. Attach it to the opposite end. Like this. Remove all the burrs and wax the surfaces and teeth of these two parts. Now parts number 47. We have two of them. Feed them all the way in at both ends.
До конца.
Remove the burrs.
И можно немножко.
You can sand and wax the bar to have a smooth surface.
И смазать воском.
Put it aside. Now, parts number 49 and number 50. Board number 6. Вот они. Put them together as well. And wax the edges.
Торцы.
Then we take gear number 51. We put it aside in the beginning. Sand it. And fit it all the way on. Then we attach three parts number 52.
Они остались на.
They are left on board number 2. This board can now be discarded. Attach the three parts to our axle.
На ось нашу.
Remove burrs.
Заусенцы. Хорошенько зачищаем, так как здесь будет серьезное трение.
Это and sand as this серьезно. Is the area of some harsh friction. This axle and gear will be cranked by a hardy-gardy handle and the friction there will be proportionally high. Then, we should wax all three washers and gear teeth.
Теперь берем наш корпус.
Now we can take the hardy-gardy body.
И будем.
And begin to assemble these parts. Wax inside the hole and the surface.
Саму плоскость. Туда устанавливаем.
There we install this unit right into the hole. As you can see, the instrument gets driven as we rotate.
Вот
Then we need part number 53. We had it on board number 2. Wax the hole inside 2. And the surfaces on both sides. You can also wax here.
Устанавливаем эту деталь таким образом.
Feed this part like this one to avoid jamming of the pins. Next, we should feed this part into the hole of part number 53. You can wax this end.
Также вот этот, вот эту часть.
As we can see, our gears match. Now we can install the decorative plate that holds all the parts together. Fit it to the axles and washers. Align. And try to place the pins in the back deck holes.
Защелкиваем корпус.
Push to lock the body and the parts we have just fitted. Here's what we should get. Next, install unit C. Fold back the string holder and match all pins, gear holes, and close the front deck.
Отверстие под шестеренки и закрываем верхнюю деку.
Check that all parts rotate smoothly. Here we can see the symbol check. Our assembly works fine. Now we can install decorative elements, parts number 98, on the sides of the body. You can find them on board number 7. Here are the parts. Take them all out. Here's how to feed them. They have a wide and a narrow part.
Можно
wax the corners.
Смазать. Уголки. И чуть-чуть сжимаем.
And carefully feed them, slightly squeezing the body.
Потихоньку одеваем.
On one side and on the other.
Итак,
feed all 10 parts until they lock.
До щелчка.
Take your time. If a part gets broken, you have 2 replacement parts. One side is done. There's a small burr on the wood that should be removed by sanding.
Зачистить наждачной бумагой.
Now we have completed the body. This is the unit D. Now we can assemble the neck. The body can be put aside. We'll start from the tangents, parts number 58 and number 59 on board number 8. They are different by their hole sizes. Take out one part number 58 and one part number 59, marked number 1. This is the first tangent. If we put them side by side, we can see that one part is bigger at the bulge. It should be on top. Now take part number 3, the pegs, and join these 2 parts. Our first tangent is made. Repeat the steps for all the 6 tangents. Tangent 3. Tangent 4. Tangent 5. Tangent 6. 5 more pegs to join the tangents.
Гвоздиков, чтобы скрепить клавиши.
Tangent 4. Tangent 5. And tangent 6. The tangents are completed. We can put them aside for a moment. Now, we can assemble the gears which will be used to tune the strings. We need parts number 66 and number 67 on board number 5. This is the set. We also need gears number 68. Here are two of them. Parts number 66 and number 67. Take care to avoid confusion. One part, number 66, has two holes, while the other one has none. We should have two axles, each has string holes. Like this. Remove burrs on the gear. Wax the surfaces and teeth.
И по плоскости, и на зубцах.
Not too much. Insert the axles into gear holes
в отверстия шестеренки, чтобы с противоположной стороны
to have string holes on the other side.
Отверстия под струны.
Like this. Now, take gear set number 70, number 71, and set number 69 with small axles. Insert axle into the B gear number 70 and fit the small gear number 71. Do it all the way through. It is desirable to have them in the same direction. Now, they should be given some waxing at the teeth, axle tips, and sand on the surface. Put them aside with the tangents and go to the neck. We start the assembly from the mid-neck. We'll need part number 64 on board number 6. And parts number 72 and number 73 on board number 8.
73.
We need two parts number 73 and one part number 72. The parts have arrows to avoid confusion during assembly, as these parts have a longer and a shorter end. Match two arrow marks together and fit the part short end first. Part number 72. Similarly, match two arrows and fit the part below. And part number 73, match two arrows and fit the part into the third hole. Now we should fasten the parts. To do this, we need parts number 40. Take out three pieces. Wax them. Insert and fasten them. Next, part number 76. Fit it into the lower part's hole. Wax the pin and take extreme care during fitting. You have a replacement part in case of damage. The part should be fitted in a way to match the round and rectangular holes. Now we need unit E1 we assembled earlier. Fit it into the big hole. You can apply some wax to the axle base. The small gears, unit E2. Go into the small hole. Next,
вторую половину.
Take the second half of the mid neck.
Это деталь с номером.
This is part number 65.
И
and fit it on top. Align the axles and holes and lock the piece. We need three more parts, number 40. Put them through the corresponding holes. Then we need part number 75. Here it is. It has four springs. Wax the spring edges. This part should be put through three planes. You can use the helper. Like this. Look it on this side too. With part number 40. And here's what we get. Now, we need part number 77. Wax the pin and fit the part into the next hole. A bit wrong. Here we are. Match the hole. And part number 78. It also has springs. Wax the springs and put them through these two parts. Lock it with pack number 40. Take part number 85 out of board number 6. The part is fitted with its print towards the rounded part of the neck. You can wax the locking points for a better fit. Now the part is fitted. Let's assemble the key box now. We need part number 60 on board number 8. The set of parts number 61 and number 62. Carefully extract it. One part is spare, and part number 62. Now you should correctly position the key box to have the numbers facing you. The rubber band pins are at the bottom. You can see the pins to which parts number 61 will be fitted. Wax them inside first. Don't forget the inside of the holes. And the pins themselves. Now fit part number 61 and then part number 62. It goes in two holes, is locked with a pin, and fastens part number 61. Fit all the parts one by one. Done. Now, take the set of parts number 63. We need 5 pieces. These parts should be fitted in a way to have the hook away from parts number 61 and number 62.
То есть, если мы перевернем,
this means that when you turn the assembly around, you will see that the hooks are reversed.
Если очень туго вставляется, можно
wax the holes in case of resistance.
И теперь нам понадобится
now we need one rubber band.
Одна. Складываем ее пополам.
Fold it in two.
И задеваем за
and attach to a hook.
Теперь
now the band should be run through all hooks.
Зигзагом.
Thus forming a sinuous pattern and attach it to the back side.
Одеть с противоположной стороны.
Here we are.
Получилось. Дальше.
Take the next part, number 80. It has printing, so the printing should be turned away. We have to attach another rubber band that will run inside. This rubber band softens the operation of the tangents. Just run it through the hole and attach to the hooks like this.
Вот так.
Then, take part number 74.
Это у нас
out of board number 5.
Вот
here it is. Fit it into this hole
сюда. Фиксируем.
And lock with part number 40.
Обратите внимание, что с этой
please note that the part has a printing on its face and its backside is blank, so the printing should face up. Here we are. And now let's install our key box here.
Нашу клавишную панель. Таким образом, чтобы сторона
the key box should be installed in a way to have the numbered surface attached to the side panel.
К боковинке. Дальше нам понадобится
средняя часть. We need the mid neck we assembled earlier.
Мы собрали. И ее мы совмещаем.
Align it against the holes in the neck side and join them.
фиксируем.
Лак.
Крайние.
Two H pins with parts number 40.
Шипа деталями номер 40.
This particular pin should be locked with part number 110. This piece is distinguished by a more complicated decorative pattern. Here we are. We need two more parts, number 110. Here. Next, take unit E1 and install it in the mid-neck big hole.
На средней части грифа,
and unit E2 in the small hole.
Проверяем между собой шестеренки вращаются.
Check rotation of gears.
Мы закрываем.
And cover the assembly with the right neck panel.
Грифа,
part number 79. The panel should be placed in face-up position.
Совмещаем шипы.
Align the pins and holes and feed the panel. Align the key box pins.
Клавишной панели.
Press it all the way down. Now we have to lock the panel on this side following the same steps. We need three parts, number 40. And three parts, number 110. Here's what we get. Now we should install decorative plates. Left and right parts number 90 on board number 8.
Правая и левая, и фиксируются они.
These parts will be locked with parts number 3. Pegs. The part is asymmetrical.
Там, где,
the part with one leaf
листик должна
should be placed between two decorative elements.
Двумя декоративными элементами.
The part on the back side has two leaves. Same here. Now, let's assemble and install the string holder. Find the set of parts number 95, 96 and number 94 on board number 8. And extract parts number 95 and number 96. Join them like this.
И дальше одеваем детали.
Fit part number 94.
Возможно, ее
придется. You may need to sand and then wax it. Here you can see holes provided for this part. The part is locked on the back side. With this decorative droplet.
Тут есть лицевая часть.
Attach the droplet with its face towards you.
Дальше нам.
Then we should fit part number 97, and then part number 3. We need two pieces. Lock the part with the pin on the back side.
Зафиксируем ее шипом. И таким образом.
It is now held in place with this part.
Вот.
We also should fit a pin on the back side to limit the movement. Of our holder.
Шип, который будет не пускать наш держатель дальше, чем нужно.
Now we can install the tangents. Start from tangent number one. To install it, set the tangent in the hole and lift the hook. Then push the tangent into the opposite hole and the hook will go into the tangent hole, thus providing its resilience. To lock the tangent, we need parts number 89 on board number 8. Wax the pins and fit the tangent into two holes like this. Pins first. Tangent will not come off its place, while at the same time providing resilience. Take out all parts number 89 at once. Fit them and install the tangents one by one. Check the number on the key box and install the corresponding tangent on top. Then, tangent number 3 tangent number 4 Tangent number 5 and the last tangent number 6. All tangents are in their places. Now we can place the decorative cover part number 91. We need two parts number 92. To do this, fit one part to the cover
and
And the second part to the neck. Align the part on the cover.
Деталь, одетую на крышку, и соединяем.
And attach it to the second one.
Так.
The cover is attached.
И теперь соберем колышки.
Now we can assemble the tuning packs.
Нам понадобится детали.
First, we need parts number 81 and number 82, which can be found on board number 4. We have the set of washers number 86. We will use them too. Join two parts of a pack. Take two washers number 86. Send the washers. Wax the back ends and feed the first washer here. The second washer should be run through these holes. To do this, wax this area, feed the washer and push it at the end. Thus, we have the tuning pack number one, a long one. Now, the pack number two, join parts number 83 and number 84. Wax the washer areas the same way.
Места, куда нужно будет одеть шайбы.
And fit the washers. The tuning packs are completed, and now we have to install them. We need part number 87. Two of them. And part number 88. It can be found on board number 1. Here's the tiny thing. We need two of them too. Now we need to feed the big and small packs. Take the big pack
продеваем его.
And run it on the left.
Грифа.
Through the three holes in the neck. We should place inside gear number 87. Wax its surface and teeth.
Вот сюда. Хелпером подправим, и нам нужно.
Use the helper to fix the gear. The tuning peg should be installed in a way that allows to push this peg here through the gear on the back side.
Вот здесь. Протолкнуть. Этот колышек.
Now, as we turn, we can see that the peg has run through, and we can also see the hole into which this lock should be installed. Use the helper to run the lock all the way through.
Поставить до упора.
One tuning peg is done. Feed the tuning peg number two, following the same procedure, with the only difference that the gear should be waxed and fitted between these two planes. Round the peg, turn a bit and lock. The tuning peg number two is fitted too.
Теперь у нас осталась одна деталь.
Now we have one part number 40 left, which has not been installed. On this side. Our neck is completed.
Теперь мы можем установить его.
And we can now install it on the body.
Нашим корпусом.
Before doing this,
нам нужно смазать хорошо воском.
Thoroughly wax these pins.
И
hooks,
крючки, и обязательно вот.
And don't forget about this rounded area.
Теперь,
to install the neck, гриф, we should put the pins in these
вот
four holes.
Попасть вот в эти четыре отверстия.
And attach it to the bottom deck with the hooks.
За нижнюю деку и
and tilt the neck. As you can see, these parts came into the holes. That's how it should be. Now, join the neck and body by pushing them towards each other. Push the neck a bit more all the way until it clicks. The neck will stop in the hole. You should hear this loud, specific click. Now, all parts are installed and rotate easily. We should assemble the wheel crank. And then we can fit strings and tune the instrument. For the crank assembly, we need parts number 99 and number 100. You can find them on board number 4. Here they are. I have troubles extracting them, so I cut the cross pieces. And the parts come out easily. Then we need parts number 101 and number 102. Parts number 101 can be found on board number 5. Here's this set, and here are parts number 102. Connect the axle parts. Here we can see minus and plus symbols on one side. Walks the axle.
Нашу ось. И на ту сторону.
And fit two washers number 101 on the part with the plus symbol.
Номером 101.
And one part, number 102, on the side with the minus symbol. Do this all the way through. And one part, number 101. Send the trims and roof edges
и смажем
and wax the washers
воском.
Now, take part number 103, and we'll need parts number 104 as well. Wax contact surfaces at the holes.
Места напротив отверстий для деталей.
To facilitate connection and fit all parts one by one. Done.
Теперь вставляем нашу ось.
Now insert our axle inside. The minus and first, the end with the big and small washers.
Минус. И
take part number 105. It should be fitted on top. To do this, wax the pins as we have quite a few of them, and the aligning may be a challenge. Align all pins. Here we have the crank. We can work it in a bit to ensure that all parts rotate freely. Next, part number 102. To fasten our crank, take out parts number 106 put them together, align and fit the crank. You can wax the pins in the smaller hole. Like this. Here we have the completed crank. Now the crank should be attached to the instrument. To do this, feed the crank onto this pin. It requires some force, so you can wax the pin.
Так.
Lock it with part number 111, found in the set on board number 1. By putting it all the way through the hole. We can see that the handle that cranks the main wheel does it freely.
Ручка, которая приводит в действие колесо основное.
Note the rotating planetary mechanism inside. Now, let's attach the strings and tune the instrument. To complete the assembly, we should assemble the holder. We need parts number 109, number 107 and number 108. As you can see, we have a number of spare parts left. You can use them if you did something wrong or broke apart. The holder is quite easy to assemble. Join the parts like this to have the prints outwards. You can wax the connection. The decorative element locks the holder at the bottom. We can clear all unnecessary tools. All we need are the strings, rosin, and maybe the knife. The model set includes this string. There's just one string, which should be divided in two. You can either do it at once, or attach the whole string, cut off the loose end, and use it at the second string. This is what we are going to do. Let's start with the first string. Put the crank down, and run the string through the first right hole
в первое отверстие справа. Таким образом, чтобы у нас остался.
Ensuring that there's a 7-10 centimeters long loose end.
Сантиметров 7-10. Теперь
этим
кусочком.
Make 5 turns and run it through the initial noose.
И пропускаем ее в первый виток.
Tighten the noose.
Thank you.
Here we have the first knot. Before attaching the strings, you can sand finish the wheel as it may have wax stains or burrs, which we had missed.
Сборки или где-то мы что-то не дочистили, то можно
sand the wheel surface once more. Now it's sanded. Important. We should apply the rosin from the model set to the wheel. The rosin increases the friction of the strings against the wheel, and we get the sound we are looking for. Thoroughly. Apply rosin to the wheel to make it smooth. The extra rosin can be removed. Then, when tuning, we can apply some more rosin. But now we can attach the strings. Run the first string through the right hole and the hole inside, which is also on the right. Like this. Then turn the tuning pegs to see both holes.
Таким образом, чтобы видеть оба отверстия. Вставляем леску.
Insert the string on one side.
Во второе отверстие выводим ее.
And run it out through the second hole.
И теперь мы можем немного отступив завязать.
Now we can make a knot. And cut the loose end at about 5 centimeters space. Now, turning the tuning peg, tighten the string. Doing so, we reel the string and make it shorter, which increases the string tension. Make sure that the string is attached properly in this place.
Вот здесь.
Here we can stop for now. We'll fine-tune it a bit later. It was the melody string. Now the second string. This is the bourbon string or bass string. This string is made of the second half of the chord. Similarly, run it through the hole, leaving a small loose end. Make 4-5 turns. And run it through the initial noose.
Затягиваем и
then tighten the knot. Run the string through this hole. You can release the holder. And through the leftmost hole. Similarly, run the string through these two holes. Pull the string on the back side and make a note. The loose end can be cut. Now turn the small tuning peg to reel the second string. Make sure that the string is attached properly and tighten it. The assembly is completed. Let's move to the tuning phase. To correctly tune our instrument, we need a piece of the supplied rosin and apply it to the wheel and crank it a couple times to have the rosin apply to the entire wheel surface. Then the first melody string should be positioned in a way to make the straight line on the main wheel and on the tuning peg where the string is fastened. In the result, we should have a straight horizontal line
горизонтальная линия может быть
that may have a slight tilt to the right at the tuning point.
Для того, чтобы правильно
to tune the first string correctly,
мы поднимаем
raise the second string and tune the first string. The string bass is already adjusted in the upper position.
Основание струны и путем подтягивания колышков вперед или назад мы
turn the tuning pegs forward to tune the string to the note D.
Если вам сложно ориентироваться
if it's challenging for you to tune by ear, you can download a guitar tuning app and use it for the tuning. This is roughly the sound you should get. The second string is the background string. You can synteny it with the first string or tune it to the note G, whatever you like. This string is just the background string, and you can either use just one string or add the second string, which gives the sound some surround. To tune the second string, slightly raise the first string and tune the second string to the required note. Thus, you can use both strings. See yougearsmodels.com for the hurdy-gurdy notes. I'm going to play one of these tunes now. It is called Ode to Joy. I wish you a nice time with your hurdy-gurdy. The hurdy-gurdy will look terrific in your room. You can position it on the supplied stand like this.
В таком положении.
Or like this. In any case, this instrument will inspire you for playing your favorite tunes. See yougearsmodels.com for the hurdy-gurdy notes. I'm going to play one of these tunes now. It is called Ode to Joy. I wish you a great time with your hurdy-gurdy.